Yeah, so that's the photo of me sailing, and that's what a lot of people say about me, that they see me happy only when I'm sailing. And I think that probably tells you how pissed off I am when I'm on land. I started sailing when I was 12 years old. And I started sailing in these small boats called the Optimus class, which will come up in the next photo. I'm not there in the picture. So these are small boats, which are very cheap boats. The guy who made those boats was given a challenge to make it. They make them $100. He couldn't make one, so he chopped off the front part of a boat, and that's why it's flat. The front part of this boat is flat. Then when I grew up, I started sailing these boats, which are a lot more, take a lot more physical activity, and very competitive, called laser class boats, which I sail in Hyderabad also. But I got really bored of sailing around in circles and around courses, and then I thought there's something new I had to do. I read about this guy called Bernard Moitessier, a very interesting character. He says he wants to sail for the love of sailing and not for taking part in races, but he actually took part in an around the world race where he was the favorite to win, and he sailed around the world. He was almost about to finish, and he turned around. So in the map you can see he started from Plymouth in England, he went around the world, he came around below Australia, he was going up back, but he turned around and he went to Tahiti and started a new life over there again. So that's where I started sailing. I thought I should start sailing offshore. These are boats called Seabirds, which I started sailing in Bombay. These are 100-year-old boats made of wood. These are used in sailing coast to coast in Bombay. One of the first places I went in these boats was a place called Khanderi. It's a small island 20 nautical miles from Bombay, and it was a fort from the times of Shivaji. It was an island fort. It was the headquarters of his navy, and it has a lighthouse now. So I went there sailing with a lot of old people. I was actually one of the only young guys over there who went sailing. But it was a great experience. As you can see, the wonderful lighthouse. It was the last Petromax lighthouse in India, and we had a great time. Stayed there for weekends. I went there actually 6 times in that year. Next. There was a race from Bombay to Goa. A lot of people from abroad had come. They come sailing all the way from Turkey, and they wanted to sail a race from Bombay to Goa. So we thought we'll take part in one of these primitive boats against their high-tech boats. And we are really competitive. A gang, we were 4 of us, and we sailed the race. The race is in 2 legs from Mumbai to Ratnagiri to Goa. And on the way, there's a place called Vengurla Rocks. And you have to go out of 20 miles and then come back in to go to Goa. But we wanted to win, so we took the shortcut, cut through the restricted area. And we went so fast that you can see in the map, instead of going to Goa, we landed up in Karwar. And we didn't finish the race. Next was sailing from Kochi to Kavarati and back in 2008. So with sailing long distances over 4 and 5 days came big challenges. One of the first one was, when do you sleep and where do you sleep? So you can see the boat is very cramped. There's no space there. So we used to sleep on the deck. We sleep only 20 minutes in 2 hours. That's 4 hours in a day. Once I was sleeping on the deck and my hand was in the water, and some creature touched my hand, and we saw a fin coming out. So we said it was a dolphin. Okay, we went back on land and told people that the fin was like that, and they said, no, it was a shark. the biggest problem is, where do you do? So there's barely enough space for people to sleep. So you see the 2 wires right next to me? You hold on to them, you hang out, and you do a thing. So these are photos. We won the race. We beat the nearest competitor by 12 hours. In this big photo, you can see the orange thing in front of me. That's a life raft. We were sinking that day, and we were ready to bail out, but we won. The next was, again, we did it in 2011. I'm waiting for the slide. 2011 we did it again, but this time they didn't allow us to go to Kavarati. They said go around Androth and come back. So this was even longer. It was 7 days. So we took part. This was a Hyderabadi team, complete Hyderabadi. I was the only guy from Bombay, but at that time I was living in Hyderabad already. We were a much more experienced team. We won the race with ease. We had some damages. You can see the torn sail. Something broke in the night. Someone repairing that. This is us sailing during a storm. Everyone's wet. The dolphins. The best sunsets, sunrises, moonrise, and moonset you guys will never see from land. And so the next question is, what next? There's no sailing happening in India, offshore sailing happening in India. So I looked up the internet and I found this race called Clipper Round the World Race. I applied for it. I had an interview, a long, very, very long, cruciating interview, which I got through. And so in 2013 and 14, I'm going to be sailing around the world. The race starts in England, goes to Brazil, South Africa, Australia, Singapore, China, USA, Canada, Ireland, and back to England. So it's going to bring up a lot of challenges. Probably I'll come back to Pecha Kucha someday and speak about them. One more thing. One interesting statistic over here. There have been more people to have gone to space than there have been guys who have sailed solo around the world. There have been more people to have climbed Everest than to have sailed around the world in teams or solo. And that's why this is like the Olympic gold for me or something. Yeah. One more thing that I want to do is sail the mini transat, which is starts from France and goes to Brazil. It's solo, and you sail in a mini boat. It's a very small boat. You sail solo. The boat has a very big sail. It's like you're driving a nano with the engine of a Lamborghini, with no power steering, and that's all. Yeah. Thank you for.